of the morning to you. It is the day after the Fed meeting, and let's see what's going on. Because yesterday, remember how I recapped yesterday's events? We had the Federal Reserve come out yesterday, and they raised rates, which we all knew that that was going to happen. But then I said, well, we need to watch for what their guidance is. What do they say? So I went through the transcripts in detail. I think I showed those yesterday at 3 o'clock. But then I started watching the videos of Federal Chairman Powell, and I grabbed some words out of there that he said, and then he had some mannerisms that also were a little odd. He made one comment to somebody asked him a question saying, you know, what do you plan on doing going forward? And he said, well, we might be close to being done. And then he just kind of moved on, and I was like, whoa, that was weird. Okay, that was really weird. So based on that, let's see what the repercussions are in the markets, because now the markets had time to digest what he said. A lot of economists and a lot of people, you know, like me, follow kind of every word he says and his mannerisms. So what I said yesterday is we're probably going to see an uptick in the stock market today. We're going to see probably bond yields come down a little bit, and they should start stabilizing quite a bit. I thought that there would be a big pullback in cryptocurrencies. And so let's go and see what happened, what the news looks like today. So right here, well, let me go back to this. Right here, you're seeing on your screen, the 10-year Treasury, the yield is up 0.03, nothing to really write home about. The mortgage-backed securities markets are up 19 on the 6.0 and the 0.08 on the 5.5. And I'll explain all this here in a minute, because if you're here for mortgages and so forth, a little bit later, a couple minutes into this, I'll really dive into that section. But let's go and see what the markets are doing. So the first thing we see here is the Federal Reserve now believes its work is nearly done. Well, that's not what he said. He made just a brief comment saying, yeah, we might be close to being done. But here's the context. Here's the one thing that I started listening to, and then I'm like, oh boy. So I don't know. This bank situation just seems odd, okay? Signature Bank came out the other day. Barney Frank sits on the board. He wrote the Dodd-Frank bill, and he said, this is political. I think they came after us because we would have been solvent on Monday. They closed us down on Friday. I think they're coming after us because of we're heavily invested in cryptocurrencies. I don't know how true that is on why they got investigated and shut down, but we'll learn soon. Silicon Valley Bank, I think it was some other issues. They were heavily invested in startups and so forth. But, you know, so that's one of the things. There's only a couple regional banks that might be in some having some issues, but the media is blowing the heck out of this thing. Okay, if you really follow this to a T, we are nothing like we were in 2008. Only nothing. Nothing like that. So just put that into context. So let's keep going forward. Stock market opens higher after Federal Reserve gains. Federal signals rate hikes near end. He didn't say that. Hildenberg, Jack Dorsey, payment. Nah, who cares about that? What Wall Street saying about the Federal Powell's comments? There it is. There it is. That's what we really want to focus in on. Fed's decision. And then right here, there's an issue right here with cryptocurrencies. So SEC plans lawsuit against Coinbase. So that saga continues to keep going. Let's see what the general markets are doing. The Dow Jones is up 275 points. I thought that was coming. Well, basically across the board, they're up. S&P's up, NASDAQ up. With the VIX is, the only thing I want you guys to look at when I follow the VIX, I look at the VIX for volatility. If the number is down, there means a little bit less volatility and less people freaking out. The number goes up. Think of it as an anxiety index. As this number goes up and up and up, people are more anxious, and there's going to be more and more trading and more speculation and things like that. You see gold. Gold's up 1%, and oil is up just a fraction of something. Let's go over here and see if there's anything in the news we need to know about. Blocks stocks tumble after short seller issues report. Blocks seller, that's in the cryptocurrency space. TikTok, I don't want to talk about TikTok. U.S. new home sales rise for the fifth consecutive month. So this is where I really want you guys to focus in on. New home sales and existing home sales. They're completely different. What new home sales are is new construction. Okay, existing home sales are houses that already been there that people put back on the market. So going forward, I really want you guys to pay attention when you see any videos, any mainstream media. I want you to pay attention if it's new construction, existing homes. I also want you to pay attention to if they say sales versus the price. Okay, because a lot of people come in and say, you know, home sales are down 85%. Well, that didn't say anything about the price. So we don't want to freak out about home sales. They're down because there's not a lot of inventory. So my focus right now is I don't think existing home sales are really going to skyrocket much. You know, they are coming to market as you're seeing on the screen. The existing home sales market should be kind of flat because most people in a current house, unless they're really forced to sell because of a job relation or something like that, you have a 4% or lower rate. And you have equity in your house because houses went up, you know, in the last 2 years. Even if you bought last year, you're probably up 10%. So over the last 2 years, you saw many markets up 20, 30%. So a lot of people have a lot of equity in their homes, and I can prove that to you with charts, and maybe I'll do that tomorrow because I'm gonna have some naysayers on this. Okay, so that's what the headlines are reading right there. The next piece of this is let's get to some real estate news. The typical down payment is 10% smaller than a year ago. A year ago, a lot of people were buying houses for cash or 20% down or more. Now we're seeing people coming into market with 3%, 5%, and the max we're looking at right now is most people are coming in with 10% of a down payment. Existing home sales rise for the first time in a year. Okay, wait. Existing home sales rise for the first time in a year. And then you go back to this headline. Where was it? This is kind of weird. New home sales, right? Okay, existing, there's where it is. Okay, that's where it really gets confusing. U.S. new home sales, fifth consecutive month, and existing home sales, first time in a year. So some existing homes are starting to come back to the markets. Okay, so that's what I want you to see there. Housing starts increase to meet rising buyer demand. I'm all for that because we need more. Just think of it this way. If you have, you know, $500,000 to buy a house and there's three of them available, it's going to be hard to buy that house because you're going to have a lot of competition. Let's say you have that same amount of money and there's 1,000 houses for sale. Well, you have a lot of bargaining power because now there's a lot more supply. So we need supply into the market to stabilize the prices of everything. All right. So what I want to talk about right now briefly is what the economy or what the futures market is telling us what the Federal Reserve is going to do. Because yesterday they said, you know, we're going to raise rates up to, well, our projection was to raise it to about the federal funds rate now to 5.25. Okay, where are we right now? We're basically about 4.75 to 5. So going forward, here's what the expectations are from the futures market at the Chicago Mercantile Exchange. Now guys, it's not me saying, hey, I think rates are gonna go down, or economists. This is where Wall Street's putting their money. Okay, so I want you to see this. So briefly, let's just go through it real quick. Here's each meeting that's gonna occur for the Federal Reserve. You can see that right through here. And here's where they're expecting the federal funds rate to be and the probability of that. Okay, so can you see we're in this range right here. So they're saying in the next meeting, we're gonna be right in this range here. So we might have another 0.25% bump coming, but it's basically a 50-50 shot right now. But look at what they're saying. Next meeting, so in May, they're thinking it might stay steady to go up 0.25%. In June, it'll stabilize wherever they, whatever they do from at the next meeting. And then from there, what are you looking at? Look at the blues. It's going down and down and down. Up through here is the federal funds rate. Okay, currently we're right in this range here. So think of it just in, you know, the end of the year, they're expecting us to be right in this range. So that is a cut in rates. So is the Fed going to pivot in a couple more months? That's what the money is telling us. Okay, that is where all the hedge funds and everything else are putting their money, and they're saying the Fed's on the brink of cutting right now. Okay, so that's that part of it. Let's go over to Bitcoin. Somebody says, why doesn't Bitcoin, oh man, I blew it. Why doesn't Bitcoin allow you to, you know, why don't more people allow you to use Bitcoin? Well, here's the chart of Bitcoin so far this year. So if you saw this, you're saying, dude, I'm killing it. This is probably the best investment of 2023. But am I recommending it? No, I don't recommend anything because my channel is basically educational. I tell you guys what I do. I'm not a broker, real estate, or stock broker. I don't give advice. You don't pay me for this. Please don't trade off of my recommendations. Do your own research because I'm just here for entertainment and educational values. So that's my legal disclosure. So if you look at this, you're saying, oh my goodness, look at this. This is nuts. This is going up and up and up. Okay, yes. But would you want to pay somebody in this? Say, okay, I paid you here, and now that what I paid you basically almost doubled in value. Well, no. But on the other hand, look at this. Here's what happened in the past year. down and down and down and down. So I'm not electing to take my paycheck based on this because, you know, we're down 36% from where we were a year ago. I don't need that. My, you know, it's hard enough to make money in today's world. So let's get over to the economic headlines for today and really dissect these. Building permits, like we said, we need more new homes being built. The number of permits that were issued previously was 1.339. They expected, the economists, when I say they expected, it's a lot of economists who give these forecasts. They expected 1.524 million permits to come in. It came in at 1.55. So that's up. I'm comfortable with that. Again, more supply with equal demand is going to cool off prices. Initial jobless claims. This is that area where it's the really part that freaks me out, but from the Fed, because they're like, we really need to raise the unemployment rate. Well, this is an area that's really concerning right now. But the people that filed for the first time unemployment claims, the previous reading was 192,000. They expected it to increase up to 197. It actually dropped a little bit to 191. I'm not looking into that because it's not that big of a miss. Remember about a month or so ago, the jobs numbers, they expected about 180 people to get new jobs, and it came in at over 500,000. That's when it's a shocker. New home sales. This is new homes. Remember, guys, not existing. The previous reading was 633,000. They thought it was going to come in at 650. Came in at 640. Why that is, I don't know, but it's not that far off of the expectations. All right, so let's see what all this data is doing to the markets right now. So here's what we're showing on the screen. This is the mortgage-backed security bond that trades on Wall Street that is the biggest component of your mortgage rate. So that's why I bring this up on the screen. So all that you need to know on this is, you see the number there? That's the price of the bond. So what you need to know is if the price of this bond goes up, like you're seeing right now, rates are coming down. So there's an inverse relationship. If this number goes down, like you've seen most of this chart, that means rates are going up. So the bigger this number goes up or down, well, the bigger the rate adjustment's gonna be up or down. So 14 is decent. It might give us a 0.05 reduction in rates, really nothing. Probably most banks won't even, you know, repost rates because of that. They'll just stick with what they have. So where are rates today? Well, let's check and see where they are yesterday because they're not posted yet. This is from Mortgage News Daily. What they do is they survey lenders all over the country and give you an average of what rates are in each category that you're seeing on your screen. Now on your screen, what you're seeing is the top six products people use when they're buying or refinancing a home. So you can see right here, the 30-year fixed rate now on average is 6.45. You know, so what I want you to understand is I just want you to look at this number right here. Okay, so here's what happens is, let's say yesterday you called me and you're like, Dan, what's my rate? And you have low credit scores, you're not putting much money down and so forth. So your rate yesterday was 6.99. Let's just go 7, just to make it simple. Okay, 7%. So now we didn't lock in because, you know, there was uncertainties in the market. So now we want to figure out what my rate is today. So we go in and all I need you to do is really go here and look at this and say, oh, it's down 0.3. So if yesterday we were at 7, today you might be at 6.7. Okay, so that's what I want you to watch on this. So if your rate is higher than this, there's probably a reason. If your rate is lower than this right now, there's probably a reason. You might have tremendous credit scores, putting more money down and so forth. So usually the higher, well, how this works is the higher your credit score, the more money you put down, and the better the rate you have. So that's basically how it works in a nutshell. So my name is Dan Frio. I do the rate update every day. I come back at 3 o'clock each day to do a live report so you guys can ask me any questions about real estate, bonds, cryptocurrencies, the stock market, the Fed, whatever you want, because I'm an open book. Please use my knowledge to help you guys make financial decisions in a prudent way. So if you find value in my channel, guys, all I ask you to do is give me a thumbs up, subscribe down below, hit the bell, because every time I post a video, you'll get an alert, even my live events. So take care, guys. God bless. I'll see you at 3 o'clock on our live event so I can answer any questions that you got at that time. Take care. See you then. Bye-bye.